This is the worst we've seen in a month. It comes after the U.S. has announced that it has killed two al-Qaeda in Iraq, two very, very senior leaders. Set the stage for us. What might this attack be?
Ali, according to Iraqi officials, at least 61 people have been killed and over 100 wounded in a string of attacks today that targeted mainly Shiites. Now, as you mentioned, Iraqi and U.S. forces killed the two most senior al-Qaeda and Iraq leaders just days ago. And while nobody has yet claimed responsibility for these attacks do bear the hallmarks of al-Qaeda and Iraq-style attacks. Ali?
Al-Qaeda in Iraq would be an organization that is mostly comprised of Sunnis. Would that be right?
Yes, absolutely. That's right, Ali. And the concern here is now is that are these attacks going to continue? Look, after these leaders were killed, you heard Iraqi officials say that they were predicting that there could be retaliatory strikes. Could happen very soon. You heard U.S. officials here, U.S. military officials saying that while this may be a devastating blow and setback to al-Qaeda in Iraq, everybody had to be on guard here because al-Qaeda could regroup and could carry out devastating attacks. While we don't yet know if al-Qaeda is behind these attacks, we do know that these are attacks targeting Shiites.
Right.
And it is a type of attack that would be sectarian violence. So that's what's raising the concern is,
right.
Is al-Qaeda regrouping? Are they resurgent? Are they able to do this? Will they be able to continue?
Alex? And if it's sectarian, does this affect that very delicate space that we're in Iraq right now, where there's been this election and no clear winner in terms of who forms the next government?
Ali, this is one of the biggest concerns here right now for months because it took so long to get the elections in order, to get them to happen, to pass an election law, to get the elections to not be delayed, have them happen. It was such an ordeal. For months, people have worried that the longer it was drawn out, the more prone it could be to violence, the more violence could surround this. It could stoke sectarian fears, sectarian tensions. Nonetheless, the elections happened. But since then, even though it's been heightened security, there is a power vacuum. You know, negotiations started, the hard work started, coalitions and blocs started forming so that they could get the majority number of seats in the government and form a government. But it hasn't continued. Now there's going to be a manual recount in Baghdad province. That's going to set things back even further. Could be months before we see any of this resolved. And everybody here has been concerned. The longer this goes on,
yep,
the more there could be violence.